a mai i a lautisipaia. Faifora mai sau pepa ia ko sau api mo a tātou whamomonga ina ia mawhai o no tou seili o tou lawa no whanga ma lou teimi pe mata e whamaoni ia la tātou whasoa i teimi tātou te whatasi mai ai i nei. This is an exploration of God's will in the Bible, and as you have seen me every night and the mornings, we use the Bible as our textbook, and if you have a Bible at home, you can bring it along, and you can also bring a paper and a pen so that you can take some notations. At some point, we're going to provide you with a Bible as a gift for participating in our Bible study. The Bible, again, is like a map. It is the expression of God's will. This is where we go to find what God has in store for us. It is a measure. It is something that will give us guidance as we continue to live our lives here on earth. That is the basis of our sharing each evening and morning. Let me give you a preview of what's coming. Tomorrow we meet twice in the morning. We meet at 10, and this will be my topic, 10 o'clock in the morning. God's eternal law. God's kingdom is governed by God's laws, and we will explore those laws tomorrow morning at 10. You can also invite a friend. Tātou vasenga soaipa umar pōne nei, o le tūlāfono a lea tua. Mā o tātou vasenga le nāe whātiroina le tāo sifuri le tāiao, au mai ia sa wō polo wāinga mō le tātou whāsoa i le teimi lea. I ele mā longa pūpū le vā o le afor sifuru, kōta le afor sumatasi, a na kōta le sumare lua, o na so le amang tātou ma tā upe lua o le tāiao a tāiao. Here's our topic, second topic for tomorrow morning. God's rest, the Bible calls it the Sabbath. God's rest, and that will be at about 11:45 approximately tomorrow morning. So we have two sessions tomorrow. And again, as mentioned by our host, the pastor of the Samoan congregation who are sponsoring these meetings, you are welcome to stay with us for the afternoon. We have luncheon, and for those who were able to stay behind last week, it was a very good lunch. And again, we are inviting you to stay with us for that lunch after the second session tomorrow afternoon. We have no meeting tomorrow evening. They said that to the same way, if you have to be at the end of the story, I will have to feel that to start Sunday evening at 7. Sunday evening at 7, we will meet again. And this is my topic for Sunday evening. Family is for life. This is a special presentation on the family. You may want to invite your home family, your spouse and your children to be here. Everybody will be blessed as we explore God's will for the family. Tātou tāo whakto le fiafio le sasām o le āinga. Mai wala uia oe le ia au mailu āinga ato tātou te whakomo. Au whakso mai e le tūspaia le fina nalo le atua molo āinga i le teiminei. Well, here's our little segment on health-wise. This is an interesting study, but it's not one or the only study on life expectancy for us. But it's a study that came out of New Zealand just this year. Yeah, le sa ilinga name and from Zalanga le nei, o lo lungo le ia la fa malo le natu mo lo oto si le fia. Pe a feita to te ola iso langa vivesi, stressful lifestyle. Nā wenga, o kone i mea tau tupe, se yo la mafo i mā fitanga e le tofi mā lie, whātasi ma isi o langa e pe o la ula ula ma le inu ava. E mawhai e le vevesi lea ma le tua e ngā o langa lea o na wha matua ina i tātou televave, na e lo tau sanga o la tātou soifuanga. O le lifo mai lea o John Mayhew, o ia lea o lo vaeira i le au lea a New Zealand o le Warriors, sa ta alo i le All Blacks, i le sa ilinga po le suesuenga le Sovereign Insurance, tau sanga le ma sino me mua sifunsu mo leono, ya ia le whamatalanga o le sailinga le le tala le fomaile nei o ila tōlo ola i msila ua nua tausanga e matua atuai o nātou tino nei lo tausanga o le soifuanga o nol tūlanga le o leolanga le desi whātasi male ula ula male inu ama. This study is significant, and as I said, this is not the only study. There's a difference between your actual age and the biological age of your body. But if you're somebody who somehow is governed by stress, whether those stress comes from work, or you're worried about your finances, or you are involved in a stressful relationship, including risky, healthy behavior, such as smoking and drinking. You are a lot older in terms of your body. Your biological age is a few years older than your actual age. Ole fe aula mo tato ile fia filine. Tato tau mo fai e fai ti tia le ola iso langa vevesi. Ta fai foi oia se te ngato ula pe inu ava. E vave ona e matua ma vave ona e oti pe a fai e le tau fia ia mea i lou soifuanga. O tu me tau ina e eni ta ngata tau te doi la iti a eva a iei pe se i ua se fuatu tau sanga le matua. E ma fua le mele na, ma e se senga le na le mele ta ua o lo biological age o le matua o lo tino ia ma matua o tau sanga o le soifuanga le nei. Ta ua la ia tatou le mahatu ma mafu fau. Aua ni vave o na fole o funina, o na o loku kole ma le atu atu vale i mea le au ngā o le soifuanga. A o tenu nei, wa ele tatou pepa o tatou tenu ngā fisili, lima tatou fisili o tatou mata upu o le pole a susa. Lima avanoa tau te tani mai i le sao po le sese, a maera o na tarina tatou fisili efa ma o popo le tatou o fei ngā ruenga. E yei le tongi, po le tongi, po i la to e fat maoni a tatu te nga fisin. Again, simply put down the word true if you think the statement is correct or false. If the statement is not correct, we will have awards for those who are participating in our Bible quiz and will score very high at the end of this series of meetings. Silasila e luma o le ia o le tātou fisili mō mō le nei. O le maunga i le tū i sa sae o le a aituai o Yerusalema. O le ngora mātua puelea i le tū i sa sae o le aituai o Yerusalema o le maunga o Moria. Sao pēsise. The mountain to the east of the old city of Jerusalem is Mount Moriah, true or false? To silalo e awa le teranoa. Rua, Jesus is coming back to forgive our sins. True or false? Pe a toe fio mai e su ilona fio fa'alua mai, e fio mai e fa' ma ngalo a tatou wanga sala. Sa'o pēsise. Tātou fesili, pole whamtelanga lona tonu e whama natu ai, na tātou mata upu i le toi fio mai o Iesu maripo na sa ua mawai. E le aiseisi na te loina le te mitonu o le fio mai o Iesu. Sa'o pēsise. No one knows the time of Jesus' second coming. Again, the question is about the time of Jesus' return. No one knows the time of Jesus' second coming. True or false? Fasilie fa. E na o le tasi le failonga o le fio mai o Yesu. O le lole o ia ia o le langi ua a fio mai. Sa'o pēsise. The only sign of Jesus coming is when he appears in the clouds of heaven. True or false? Ia mana tātou te sini mune muli, o la tātou whaamanatu o le whiawhio nei. O le whio mai o Iesu whaalua e whio mai whaalilolilo. Sao pese. The second coming of Jesus will be a secret event. True or false? Again, this is a review of our previous topic or our last topic, which dealt with the coming of Jesus. Our Lord Nemo Tato Fingalwema, please pass your cards to the aisles. Pasipasi yu tuku lau pepa I au tafa. Ae au ina la tato pepa le naa fate le vabe. E a tato feya oma o ne te tau o na makaina a tato pisili. Toe fa'a natu atu, tusi lo suafa, Malon tua tusi ina iei dotono, ia le mea tuki ai, ia utali ole afi afi nei. Want to remind you, it's important that you write down your name and your address, because we are keeping a tally of your scores, and some people will receive a gift at the end of this series of meetings on the basis of your participation in our Bible quiz. Kartai fo'i mo tātou whengalwenga lo iai I le potu oi fafo, ma le tātou laulau re se tala mo le wha'a māo topoina o a tātou ngalwenga I pe o tātou tani ngā pisili. I hope you still have your pencil or pen so that you can fill in our prayer request card, which needs to be dropped off at the foyer on your way home. I also encourage you to take reference of some key passages of scripture and some notations from tonight's presentation. But let's go to our five statements or questions for tonight. Let me read this to you, and I expect you to give me the correct answer. Here's our first question. The mountain to the east of the old city of Jerusalem is Mount Moriah. True or false? What do you say?
True.
Let me see the hands of those who say it's true. Be bold. True? Put your hands right up. The answer is false. The mount to the east of the old city is the Mount of Olives. The Mount of Olives. Mount Moriah is within the city. Within the city. That's the site of the temple. O le tali e lo moria e le tuki sasae a le mauma o olive. Shame on you. Second question. See, you thought the last time with this question it was kind of easy. Well, it's starting to be difficult. Here's the second question. Jesus is coming back to forgive our sins. True or false? What do you say?
False.
You may recall when we started the presentation, I shared with you a Bible reference from Hebrews in the second part of the Bible, the New Testament. Hebrews chapter 9, you may remember. And we looked at a couple of verses. But when it comes the second time, He doesn't come to forgive our sins. He actually comes to take us, to save us. It's what I call, it's the cream on top of the cake. It is the last part of the salvation act of Jesus. O le tali e le ai, pe a fiu mai e su whanua, e fiu mai e le ina I a whamangano a tātou o sala, a ina I a veina I tātou ma whaoleina. O le tātou fesilia tolu. Here's the third statement and a question. No one knows the time of Jesus' second coming. What do you say?
True.
You may recall that we spent some time in the two chapters of Matthew. Again, Matthew is the first book in the second part of the Bible, the New Testament. Chapter 24 and 25. In 24, we looked at a parable of the thief and how Jesus used that imagery to make the point that no silly thief will give us a pre-warning of their visit, would they? They'll be absolutely silly if they do that, because we'll be waiting with a 2x4 timber for them to come in. The point that Jesus was making is, listen, I'm coming, but nobody knows the time of my coming except my Father in heaven. Ole tali ilvisiri lea eleai. We know by the conditions of the world that Jesus is coming soon. The expression is, he's at the door. Here's the fourth question or statement. The only sign of a Jesus coming is when he appears in the clouds of heaven. What do you say? True or false?
True.
It is important for us to allow the Bible to speak for itself. Again, in Matthew chapter 24, in the first three verses, and in response to the question from his disciples, there were two questions. Jesus, when is the end of the world? And the second question was, what is the sign in the singular? What is the sign of your coming? In the same chapter, that is chapter 24, a little later, I think it's verse 31 or 35, where Jesus said, when you see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven, so that's the sign of my coming. The only sign is when Jesus appears in the clouds of heaven, the answer is true. The second coming of Jesus will be a secret event. What do you say?
False.
You may recall as we conclude our study the last time, which was Sunday evening, here are some things we need to remember again about the coming of Christ. Number one, when he comes, people will be able to identify him, for he will come in person. Number two, people will be able to see him because according to Christ, he will sit on a cloud. The third statement that we made based on scripture is that when he comes, we shall hear the trumpet of God. So the coming of Jesus is an audible event, the trumpet of God. And I guess there will be other sounds, just like royalty coming into a city. And finally, there's a physical resurrection of the dead. In Christ, they shall rise first. To Awa fa'utalanga ola ta tomata upu ole afi afinei. Well, let me take you for a little travel as we introduce our subject matter for tonight. My one wanted to spear. O te fia'ame o tou ila tu nu'u o ai kupito. I want to take you to Egypt. Take you to about the middle of Egypt, where the river Nile flows, a place called Luxor. Ave o tou le aeta o Luxor, mana tuan fa'asimori o le Lux. Tu iei ma le o ma le a Luxor. O lo iei lo ngā tutonu le tunuru me tafe elewe tafe o le neila. I want to take you to an interesting place where the pharaohs of yesteryears were buried. But this is where we start our trip. Vaina le mai le fa malama le faltani malosa o nofo ai ba ia tu mo mo se ba e mo le neila. From the window of my hotel looking at the river Nile. This is the main street at Luxor. But I want to take you to the western side of the river Nile. Avere tanto va semele tu isisifo o le vaitafe o le neia. Take you across to the western side of the Nile. Nisi o fata mata e fa feilo ie tanto o la iatu I va hevo le lofenua e ta ua o le valley of the queens and the valley of the kings. Rotatu a mai fenua tanu o masiofo matupu o farao iaso ia o le tuspa ia ua mavai. E ere mai mawre ne ta omo la uto si de sire na fefe ne. Here is an important place to visit. This is the place supposedly where Moses' mother, the daughter of a pharaoh, we nei lo ta oto ai ia te mai tai sa avel se pharaoh o lo nei ngoa o pharaoh Hatshepsut. O ia le o le tina fai o Mose. Pe a fai tu te mantua le tale mesa ato o Mose le vai I le vai tafe o le leila muniane wa fa atama faina e le afino pharaoh. Pauleo te mai tai e whapea o se te mai tai sa nofo mai o se pharaoh. So this is the place where they have the site where Hatshepsut, Moses' Egyptian mother, the daughter of the pharaoh, is buried. This is the valley of the queens. If you have o tou I le meta ua o le whanua tanu o tupu, there are many tombs, but the one that we will visit tonight is the tomb of King Tut. Te ave o tou I le nofuanga sa tanu ai I le tupu pito I le titi o ai kupito I aso ia o mavae a o manai e suno ni ngofa a pupu o King Tut. O le tamba lea sa tupu le iva o na tausaka King Tut became king o Pharaoh at the age of 9. And he only reigned for 10 years when he died. O le avanoa lea tatu te oai I lango o le toafa. This is the way under the desert to where King Tut was buried. I le tausaga e tasi iva lua lua, the year 1922, o le archaeologist o tangata so sue o le ele ele, Howard Carter o Peretania, uia le nā sa moa le no whanga le nei, ma o lela lango tua wha mai nisi o mata anga ma mai moa mo toenga o le te mau aingo King Tut, sa moa I le tausaga pe ono whaero atu. If you want to see some of the artifacts that were found at the tomb of King Tut, you've got to go to the Cairo Museum at Cairo, Egypt. O lo tō mai moa I le whale tele lea le whale mata anga lea. O lo te uina ai I a vaenga o toenga o King Tut. Fa tasi manisi mea sa moa I le ana. I le tō sanga le tasi afe, tasi afe iwa se lau mua sa manua. Let me take you inside. For me, the most important exhibition in the Cairo Museum is the King Tut exhibition. O I nei o iai I a toena o me I a tātou mata mata I a sova I ngana o fōlinga o le meta o le bust o le me whai le maa e tau whātania mai iai fōlinga o King Tut le tupula I titi o Aikupito. Interesting that buried together with King Tut are some of his toys. Manatua o le te maroa lepo, le tama lepo, le tama I titi. Sa tanu whātasi Maana mea ta'alo, it is tradition, you know, what we refer to very often as pyramids, or pyramito aikupito, very often those burial grounds, those are tombs of pharaohs from years to years. Ma o ainari mena toys are toys. King Tut's toys that were found together with him there at his tomb. Olesi mea le ngato meta aro ole fata e os yeita ulanga. Obviously he was some kind of a religious person. Ole tangata e tentoyu in yatua ma ole fata feita ulanga. This is made of gold. E feia ile oro. This will give us an idea. Give us an idea of the wealth. E teini a pulea e aikupito le lalulangi when Egypt before Christ was a superpower, before Babylon, before the Medes and the Persian, before Rome. Yasona e matautia le te mau aina o aikupito ma mafuangana na peutumitowina o le fata feita ulanga e feia I le oro. Another very interesting find that was left there at the tomb together with the body or the mummy of King Tut was this little boat. E eletro to numo tangata e kupito a oti le tangata. Na haumle oro na ngana ile va'a e alusisi me no fine. It was part of Egyptian mythology that when a person dies, their spirit will travel in a boat to another place. Sad for King Tut. This boat went nowhere. And when I know from the Bible that when we die, we go directly to the ground, to the soil. But that's a topic for another time, and I don't want to miss that. O le va'a mea ta'alo, sa atu e roile anango King Tut. But here's probably is the most exciting find. I want you to look at this huge container. Well, it looks like a container. By the way, this is pure gold. Ao eli ma eli ma eli Howard Carter malana au whaingawera. When Howard Carter and his team of archaeologists were digging, in fact, they nearly missed the tomb of King Tut. But when they finally were able to open up where he was kept, they came to this container made of gold. Ole oro mela, ele lo papa, ole oro. So as they eventually opened up this container, there was another container inside which is also made of gold. The talatu lazy container e oro foi. To the talatu lazy container e oro foi. Folks, these are not wood. This is gold, solid gold. O let me take you to what eventually was exciting. Now, by the way, this is a digital reconstruction of how King Tut would look like. O le tomo fainga le asaimisi le whaoaino computer. Le tomo fainga le asaili mai ia folinga King Tut. Mai e folinga mai e fapena ona folinga. Se tasio mea ua mautino nei e vai siki le tamalea. Ona e eile fale tonu ilona vai tau a mavale. But that's a digital imagery of what King Tut would look like back then. But this is the most exciting part of the find. I to tonu o containers ia oura e tonu pe no fapatalina. Ina o toita taleina, so a taatia mai eire mele o le puso mea umanafi sama sama, o le olo, again this is gold. Ma ina o te taleina le mele ha. A lese, a to a taatia mai foi nesi ta ui, o le olo, e lo se papa, o se fala lili, o le olo, this is solid gold. Solid gold. Ma ina o te tala mele, o nei loaila o le sifoi viufi e ufufi e mata. Ta ua o le death mask. O le meu ufufi e I a mata o le tenatote ta ua o le mami. Mai ina wa ese meia. O nei loaila le au fōlinga na o King Tut ua maanuminumi. Now you may ask me tonight, ladies and gentlemen, so what's the point of this exercise, this tour to King Tut's tomb? E au wan me au le soifuanga le nei ngata mai. Here's the reality.
top was actually very long.
You may pursue all kinds of things in this world, including money and wealth. And if you remember, in our very first presentation, no amount of money or gold will save us. He had all the wealth of the world in a tale of King Tut. You see, the tradition back then, and very often it is recorded in history, when an important person like King Tut dies, not only he will be buried with his wealth, but sometimes their servants will be buried alive with them. Let me encourage you, it's important to work. It's important to have a nice house. It's important to have a nice car. Lots of money to provide for your family. But I need to remind you, sooner or later, there's an end to human life. And that's it. But I want to take you to a better place. I want to take you to a place where nobody will die. Do you want to go there? Then come with me. Here's our study for tonight. Heaven, our home. Ole langi, ole tatu a in the morning. Just in case you don't know, all of us are tourists. O tatu o te mata fai malanga. This is not our home. There's a better place that God is preparing for us. And we looked at that Sunday night. That's why Jesus is coming. But for other than I feel my Yesu, e ame tatu se mea, e leto yaise oti. Let me tell you about this beautiful castle. A couple of years ago, Roto Sangato Wesa, we see our money. I was in Germany, not too far from Munich. If I am going to move us at Oyasona of Bavaria, Eyele Ololea, Oletupu, Itemina, O King Ludwig II of Bavaria. Ole Ololea, Naboa Mayea Tematalea, Olingo, O Walt Disney, Lana Ikea, E Fayai. Yelemele fatata foita made it to Disneyland or Disney World. Makukuai yele castle and all of that there and a foul my ine. I was very privileged to visit this place and I'm going to take you inside of this castle later on. Au tatu ta opul porine ole langi olo tatu ai umoni. Let me take you back here. On the other side of the castle, ilesi tu ole olole. I was able to take this picture of another smaller castle. King Ludwig II of Bavaria. 1868. King Ludwig II was the king of Bavaria, which is not part of Germany today. But on this other side of this particular picture, I was able to take another castle just below, and that's the castle where he was growing up. I'll take you inside the castle a little later. Three parts to our study tonight. No more. Ole malo ole atua God's kingdom. Lua ole no fuanga ole atua God's place. Tolu ole tapenanga marefufuanga ole atua God's plan. Those are the three parts to our study tonight. Again, heaven, our home. O le langi, o le tatu aina. So tatu aina from tilanga tu spaya fa tolu malo le tua. There are two distinct but related parts of the kingdom of God according to scripture or the Bible, which is our textbook, the Bible, our textbook. The first part of this kingdom of God is called the kingdom of grace. Twitter, or Malo, or Lea Lofa, to Noah.
Ol malone le lo fatuno, ol malone alotatu o olai ile teiminei. Ma ol malone sa fatino ina, ina wa fio mai esu ole pepe me mea I petele ema. This kingdom of grace is personified with the birth of a Jesus at a Bethlehem. Ma ole awana tatu te ulufale ele baena lo malo muamua, bae muamua malo le tua, ole fatua tua lea ia Jesu Kristo. All of us have opportunity to enter into this first part of the kingdom of God, the kingdom of grace. And you and I can enter into God's kingdom of grace by faith in Jesus. But there's a second part to the kingdom of God. This part is known as the kingdom of glory. God's kingdom of glory will be ushered in when Jesus comes the second time. That was our focus on the Sunday night. Entry into this second part, the kingdom of glory, is again faith in Jesus Christ. Let me give to you two Bible references that give support and weight to these two parts of the kingdom of God. We're looking at the kingdom of grace, and I'm going to invite you to help me as we read the text from the New International Version. And you are familiar with this biblical text. Let's read together in English. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Again, entry is accepting Jesus by faith. And guess what? When you accept Jesus by faith, instantly or right away, you have eternal life. What do you say? But there's a second part which is in the future, ushered in with the coming of Jesus. Again, let me take you to the Bible, our textbook. Now, there are a number of key concepts that I want to unpack for us tonight. I'm going to ask you again to read, then I will take some time to explain what you see on the screen. Blessed and holy are those who have part in the first resurrection. The second death has no power over them, but they will be priests of God, of Christ, and will reign with him for 1,000 years. Now, there's a word that you will find in the Bible which comes from the Greek. The word is millennium, which simply means 1,000 years. I will explain that a little later. I E se wanga e isi me lua e o te manao o te whasoi na atu mo to si le fia. Let me talk to you about the first resurrection. Do you remember, take you back to Sunday evening, when Jesus comes the second time? Part of that experience is that there will be a physical resurrection. Do you remember that? Bantua. Ba fio mai Jesus de numa night. Ta to te lo vo mai e yai le toe to tu. Now that resurrection is referred to in the Bible right here in Revelation as the first resurrection. If there's a first resurrection, there is the assumption that there must be a second resurrection. Pea fai e yaisi toa tū mō mō lona winga, e yaisi toa tū lona lua. So let me go to the bottom of the screen, take you to the end of the verse. The starting point of the 1,000 years is the second coming of Christ and the first resurrection. Are you following me? I'm going to illustrate that in a moment, but just take note. The beginning of the 1,000 years starts with the coming of Jesus and the first resurrection. E amato fetto moto sangaiafe ole meleniuma ine fio mayo Jesu marto tu ole to tu momoa. Uma le afeto sanga. At the end of 1,000 years, there will be a second resurrection. Keep that for me. So now you have the 2 points of the millennium. First resurrection with the coming of Jesus, and there's a second resurrection. I will deal with that in a moment. You notice there is also a second death. E elementa wole oti falua. I need to explain these concepts so that you know exactly what is going to happen. O tato uma ni o tematoro. All of us are humans. We know we will die. That death is known as the natural death. Po o le matua o to sanga. Po ua soa el pas. Po ua pa u le la au. E oti. The first death, this natural death, is actually a consequence of Adam's sin. The first human. We are his descendants. And because of a decision he made, death enters into our human experience. And so all of us die. That's the first death. Are you following me? But at the end of the 1,000 years, at uma le afeto san, o ina o le afa umatia ele ti apolo matangata le teliene Jesu e fa vavau. O le oti le na ta wole oti fa lua. Follow me now. At the end of the 1,000 years, there will be a second resurrection specific to the unrighteous. People who did not accept Jesus as Savior and Lord. And at the end of the 1,000 years, the Bible tells us, fire will come down from heaven, Satan will be destroyed, and those people will be destroyed forever and ever and ever. Meaning, they will not exist anymore. That is the second death. Are you following me? Yes. Now here's the good news. Don't get scared now. But here's the good news. When Jesus died on the cross, that was our topic last Saturday morning. When Jesus died on the cross of Calvary, are you listening? He died the second death for us. Amen. So that when we
accept him and his death, then his death becomes our death. And so we don't have to experience the second death ourselves. Amen. What do you say?
Amen.
Can you see why accepting Jesus is big? Because if you don't accept Jesus, you will die the second death. Ero mliu Yesu satelo karvami. Na mliu Yesu ileoti falua botato. Aona tatu tlie Yesu oli faona. Eleto oti tatu falu. Afai aeoti falua tatu. Ote te winen fasamoa ole matavale. Awa elese mafua ana eto oti ya. Awa wa umma ona mliu Yesu motato. That's how don't tell.
Amen.
Don't kill him, make it real. The kingdom of glory. On my law, on a tour, my battle. Very quickly, I will not take time. I'm just going to drop in some years and times. So, Sonia Tato, who have I on my law, on a tour? Two parts of God's kingdom. The kingdom of grace. Centerpiece, the death of Jesus. It is finished. Or umma. By my lua, ole malo, ole tua eta ua, ole malo, ole mamalu. E amata ile fio mai o Yesu, male toe tu muamua. Umma tau sanga yafe ile, toe ile, ile toe tu fa lua, ole awabi ole ana, ae toe tu mai ile fa, fano, male otie, kawau. 1,000 years. So this is the beginning of time, Garden of Eden. There's a second coming of Christ. There's your third coming of Christ. And we'll talk about it a little later. Yeah, fatasi malelangi. So just to give you some pointers, not so my one of so sorry mola or to my more. Let me fill in the gaps. Say fatumu, yeah, but I may have more to. So let me take you now to 1,000 years. A mata la feto sangale tu so farina ile a fio fago mai o Yesu. So the 1,000 years starts with the second coming of Jesus. So what happens at the second coming of Jesus? Meye tutupule a fio fago mai o Yesu. So Yesu avere o fatto tuo o de lani. O ila to o e sata ye Yesu a na feoti e to tu mai le oro fo. O ilanto wa mio le lei a le fioti temi le e li ua ilanto. Ai o le awa mio valea, e le italie Yesu, e fanno ile malo malama o ke riso ilona la fio mai. Afetu sama. Le vae nala lea a le italie ini Yesu le uo ti i. Ma o le eisi se to ola ile ele ele. O ilanto la ia ua mani liu, ma ua Fawr fyle satan i wyle o tu Iesu dyng adolau fa oso oso ina. A le o ie ma'n angen fe fatan i se i o'r men yna o le asw ba uwai e Iesu i ddelangu. So while the dead, the unrighteous, who did not accept Jesus are dead and Satan is going crazy because he don't want to be tempted in heaven because he has a second coming. Jesus and the righteous will go to heaven. For me, you know, for tupu Iesu, mare au ane o tonu i le langi. O lono nufo i le ai e tau o le Jerusalem o fo, NJ, the New Jerusalem. Ai a umato sama i afe, at the end of the 1,000 years, ma o toi fatu tu mai a ua ane o le ana. O na saule o le ai le Jerusalem o fo mai le langi. Toi tu na ua ane o le ana, toi fa seta se satani o na saula le o le afi mai le langi. Then fire would come down from heaven. After the 1,000 years, ma ole amu pa uaina to ele to ye ye fa ma ole oti fa a lua the second death. Ao ilai oso we ro upor tato muta o kuna fefil ne. Then these words of scripture would come true. Pemaifam talanga tu spaiya fa ringam ta kulusu mutasfe mumua.
Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. Ono unole le langi fo, ma le langi fo. Awa ma vai atu le wai langi, ma le wai lalo langi. Ma wale to ye fo ise sami.
I addressed that issue of the reference, there's no more sea.
Le tato mai bonga I patamu. Tato toyo, le vai ngole, olo po le castle of King Ludwig II of Bavaria. Back at the airport, tato mtau, second part of our study tonight. What is this place like? Fa pe I folingo no fuaga leo le tua. Le langi. Le la oto me te wina ma la tatu faso atu. O se no fuaga ua ta pena le le. It is a design, there's a place. There's a design, there's a plan. It's a magnificent place. O se no fuaga ma to mo fie. O se no fuaga it's a homely place. It's a happy place. Let me touch on those 5 points very quickly. A designer's place. That's a picture of Ludwig II of Bavaria. It's a well-designed place, a city, the New Jerusalem. Instead, they were longing for a better country, a heavenly one. Therefore, God is not ashamed to be called their God, for he has prepared a city for them. It's a well-designed place. This is Ludwig II's castle. What you see here is a sad part about this castle. It's full of 19 years when Ludwig became king of Bavaria. When he died, this project was not finished. The sad part about this project and King Ludwig II. He was found in a lake. Apparently a very shallow lake, not too far from the castle. O tia iwa malemo fatasi malana fo ma'i mwore mafo fo tangata wa balea. Feia king tapat. Neine uma safai. Ana oti malemo ilimai. Lea ma. Ayeno tatorunga esili atu the Jerusalem fo. The New Jerusalem is much better than King Ludwig's castle in Germany. You know, it's beyond our comprehension what God is preparing for us, because it's a well-designed place. It's a magnificent place. Or no farma, a matomofi, the streets of the New Jerusalem, heaven, this place that God is preparing for those who accept Jesus. The roads are made of gold. Auro. E o lava le ouro King Tut. King Tut's wealth and gold is kept secretly with men with machine guns protecting that wealth. A le ouro le tua. Somebody ka? Then o mo. Ouro atol me me e ila e pe o se. Tiota. Mo tamata. Kere ko mo miska mai. Fa ke pula pa ko. Fa ye. O forima. E ke la ala ai o ala mai. Se se ru mai ba mai no mata ta. No mata o fi a magnificent place. Magnificent place. It's a homely place. E ba ai mai. Ta to te masani ai in a nuclear. There are some things in this place that we would be familiar with. For some of our friends who are here, that's a typical Samoan open house. It's called
Fallen. My reading of scripture is, in heaven, we will build phallus, then we will live in them. So I'm one phallus.
Tato te fofale, mo tato mawai. Ele nata ye phallus amo.
Aye, for him a mission. In the room there.
On a fapel, elfetoma. On a tuspea. To say, I'm talking to you from the land of the Langi, if I bear. They will build Samoan forests and dwell in them. They will plant Misiruki and eat of their fruit. Lato te faya lato fatuanga, talo tamu, ufi, ufai. Motato aayai imeria. So, heaven is not totally foreign for Samoans. There are some things that we would be familiar with, like Samoan phallus, it's called in Australia, Bali houses. But it's Samoan phallus, and Samoan ladies' fingers, those sweet bananas. Langi yore no whanga mātou o fie, e whai e whai ma whaali fu whai. E whai e tama Samoa aure lady mātou. Oi sisi ale fi alu, ile langi. It's a safe place. I took this picture in New York City. Well, the largest city of the United States, but also a place where terrorists and other people keep an eye on. It's the heartbeat of commerce in the United States. You go to New York City. Took my family again there this year. To titi lava, to fule poloka, ma me fale leo leo. Every block there's a police presence. Every police presence. But in heaven, there's no need for a police force. Because nothing evil, according to the Bible, nothing evil will be found in that place. Took this picture in Johannesburg in South Africa. Few places where you can be very close to a real lion and they will not bite you. But when from Talamale, he say, the wolf and the lamb will feed together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox, and dust will be the serpent's food. They will neither harm nor destroy on my holy mountain, says the Lord Almighty. It's a peaceful place where we can be together with wild animals. It's a happy place. Yeah, I want to go to this place. Lots of nice, dressed young people entertaining us 24/7. Heaven is a nice place. I am Marisi Metawa. It's something that's special to me personally. Read together with me. This is a reference to the new heavens and the new earth. Read together with me. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain. For the old order of things has passed away. When my family traveled to this venue, every time we travel here, we would come on M1. We would take the Toronto exit. Whether it is coming here or going back to Hamlin Terrace where we live, you see the cemetery, Macquarie Lake City Cemetery, the mortuary on the right. And for me, that's a constant reminder. We may be strong, we may be rich, but one day we will die. Be a mabaso, be a mire. Peter,
ai ole no fonga nale. Eleto tiesis. I mean, I like a place where there's no death. I mean, even if we don't want to talk about death, let's talk about aging. And once upon a time, you were pretty, handsome, fast forward, and you were... But death is serious! What? I'm a family. Eleto yese so no yoroi matape ta feli su data. Eleto yese fa no no. I think I know something about death because I've lost both my parents, and this is the headstone to my parents' grave in Samoa. And this is a constant reminder to me of how ugly and bad death is. It's the reason why we really need to leave this place. So let me ask you, don't you feel all do you want to go to this place?
Yes?
Okay, then get your pens ready. Let me tell you how you can go to this place. Alright? This is God's plan. Two very important things about God's plan for us to get to this place. Number one, are you ready? Everybody needs to have a passport. I mean, nobody travels today without a passport, right? Now, here's your passport. Your passport is the blood of Jesus and faith in his righteousness. Ole pepa malango tato ile langi woi. Ole fatua tua leila me tolo kerisa moa ilona maliu morona toto. That's our passport. Let me give you the reference. From talanga ne tu spaya falim tapu ruas matasi ruas from a fitu. Take note of your passport. Only those whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. How can we get to that list? How can we get to the Lamb's Book of Life? By accepting Jesus as our Savior. Amen. For God so loved the world that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Are you serious about going to heaven? You've got to accept Jesus. Amen. You need a passport. The death of Christ. Second part. Passport. And now we are falling. In addition to your passport, you need your citizenship in God's kingdom of glory. You don't need a lawyer. And to live in our near Soloia, at our Savino Citizen, Fabene from Telana to Spaya. Again, the book of Revelation, chapter 22, verse 14. I want you to read with me. Here's our citizenship together. Blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life, and may enter in through the gates into the city. What city? The new Jerusalem. It's about obedience to the laws of God. That's our topic for tomorrow morning. If you want to go to heaven, you're going to be here at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. Because you need to get your citizenship. If you haven't learned, you have to die out. Only those who keep the commandments of God, they will have the right to enter the city and to live in the city forever. What do you say?
Amen. Amen. Lord.
So two things as I close. If you really want to go to heaven, you need a passport. and you get it tonight. Accepting Jesus as your Savior. Second thing, you need a citizenship. That's tomorrow morning's topic. But you need to be willing to take citizenship, obedience to the Lord of God. Let me close. Let me take you to an island outside the harbor of Manila. See, I don't tell you to my Lugumea. But I'm going to Lugumea or Corregidor Island. I'm at Lugumea. In a day, me or a tower on the Lugumea Lalaman. Or come at Lugumea. A pay or say, Olo Papa, Manatu, Tamate, Lemafai, a session also for here. Corregidor Island is one of those 45 places, and the Americans thought nobody would ever come into Corregidor Island. We're talking World War II, even though the Americans have been in Corregidor Island since World War I. Let me take you for a tour of these places to bring this to a close. O isa fa go tuente te awa Ameriko General Douglas MacArthur. O le te te aula al Allied Forces in te mi o le tauro le mōre o langso. Behind me is tunnels, network of tunnels. This was the headquarters of General Douglas MacArthur at Corregidor Island. O I nei I le tau sanga e tasiiva whālua in 1942. When the Japanese forces pushed from the north and they finally landed on Corregidor Island, March 1942, Fayefa Tununga al Prestedo Amika, ya Douglas MacArthur el Messi, because the Japanese were coming in force and the Americans and the Allied need to reorganize themselves. So Douglas MacArthur was taken out of Corregidor Island. In fact, he came to Australia, March 1942. So now, Leo, to Douglas MacArthur, again, we're still at Corregidor Island. I want to take you to the actual place where he left the island at night. The man of Sola is saying Douglas MacArthur. 3 years later, Douglas MacArthur came back to the same spot. Take you to it. But while in Australia, you've heard of his words. In Ofisili, Autustusia, newspaper, Douglas MacArthur, what about the battle in the Philippines? Meditala Douglas MacArthur, don't worry, I shall return. Therefore, you had a tame emotitoe for you. So again, at the pier, you will see this sign of where Douglas MacArthur was. Would you like to see Douglas MacArthur? Well, yeah, Douglas Same pier, 1942, and later, 1945, Douglas MacArthur landed right here. Remember his words? I shall return. There's Douglas MacArthur. Same pier. Same pier, coming from the right of the pier. May the Tala, ala tata I aumea. In our facility here, that after fa fair le taua, I've made la faina. Ote toe foi mai. Le taimi le nei o lote mo faile ti apoloe, fa se se, fa loto vai baita to le fofoa le tua e yele langi. E ele toi a seu mai. Ma ui lame lo manino la tātou ma ai le teimine nei o lo ye mene oti tātou te whanono ai. A upu lama Iesu e whapea o te toi sau. Jesus words to the disciples prior to his death. Yo anem tāpas fuma whāwhau kwe lua. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you I am going there to prepare a place for you. And he said, I will come again. Why don't you do something for me as we close tonight? The second coming of Christ is certain. Heaven is certain.
Mauti no le toa fio mai, e mauti no le langi. Ale pōre nei, o ia tātou le ala noa tātou te fili fili ai. Tātou te fio i le langi. Fa mata tātou te talia, le varongia i e suo te alu, le whalolo te mā, e tā pēle se nea tātou te nonofo ai. Te mele hundu mai, e tu ina kwele fisili le tātou se. Po fea o iai lau fili filina. Morning, Langley. I will come back with a question. Would you like to go to heaven? Are you willing? Do you want to be ready when Jesus comes again?
Or my God, I don't know.
Jerusalem,
Faftaile tua mo le nuu ua tapena ina le Yerusalema fou. Mo I latou o e talia Yesu o le faola maleni. Thank you, Father, for the promise of a Jesus soon return. Thank you for the assurance of this city, the new Jerusalem, prepared for those who accept you as a Savior and a Lord. Mato tu lai le tu le fiafilineo le mato filfilina e te yai I lea no fo'anga. We are standing with the conviction we want to be in that place. So sani mai le tua, awa ni tue ola fa'atala le. So sani mai le tua fa maoni mo stai atu oe saoni mo luto e fiamai. Help us, Father, to be faithful and true, awaiting your return to take us home. Ya to tole manuia le tuo nei se yo fa'va lava. Amen. Please be seated, just for a moment. La tu fa'ta semele to au mo ta tu of Christi, to have a blessing for the prophet. A reminder for tomorrow, we have two sessions. First one at 10, God's eternal Lord, our passport for heaven. There's a second session at 11:30. There's luncheon prepared for you, and we look forward to see you and your friends and the families. Bala wia loto malu watatu senga tayao tayao tu la fono malo le tu ta sfun malaysia ta tu ta opu mana ta tu tonai. And manai bala wia kono wainga malo ta tu te fie fatasi de so. There's a refreshment at the hall. As soon as you leave from here, there is refreshment for everybody. Please join us for that. Yele tatu ti, afa mire tu lo tu malu de nefia fi to fasi fuori.